You got any questions?
Do I have questions? More questions if you come on down to the seminar. You actually touched on one of them, as he always does in the spirit. Again, making sure that you are in a mindset of evolving, because it starts with something small like that. So the brother we talked to early this morning was just, as Tazadak so eloquently shared, you know, he created a problem when there was really a solution. If you take a minute to still yourself and hear God, and within, you hear, okay, you know, I need to put forth that effort and put forth that investment in myself and friends and family to really to go. And the first step is changing your mindset. And the spirit that we're in while doing these processes, you know, makes a big difference. And actually, my question was, could you explain the importance of claiming our power before even moving in our flesh to even execute the energy behind what's needed to be successful in the commercial world?
Wow, that was kind of like mind-boggling. Hold on, can you like break that down simplistic? Repeat that again, I really didn't catch that.
My bad, y'all. Let me start that over again. Breaking it down, what is the spiritual importance behind, okay, let me rephrase that. Why is it important that we're like spiritually aware and grounded before starting the SPC process? Why is it important to be aware of the consciousness and spirit that we're moving in before even starting this process? Because it's not going to work if your mindset and your spirit is not in this and that is not at the right place. That's what I mean. Why is that important?
All right, I got you. So, I mean, first of all, giving all praises to our creator, whose, you know, proper name is Yahweh. You know, giving all honors to our forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and the creator whose proper name is Yahweh. So one of the most important factors of actually, like, being spiritually, you know, connected with your creator is that a lot of people, they judge by appearance. And the scriptures, see, a lot of people claim to be spiritual, but they're really not. The scripture tells us don't judge by appearance. Case in point, what I mean by that is there are a lot of people out there, they look at a person that they think is white, right? A so-called white person, and say, oh, well, he's an Edomite. But the scriptures in Romans 8 and 16 says the spirit bears witness who's Israel, meaning who's Yahshua. So you can't really just look at a person and place judgment. That's off, according to the scriptures. You're supposed to judge them by their spirit. Because there's a lot of people that think that they're Yahshua. They think that they're Israelites, and they may be as dark as, like, you know, Wesley Snipes or someone like that. But you're going to find out that they're not Israelites. They might be a Hamite. They might be a so-called African. And that term African is real broad. But my point is they may not be of the nation of Israel. So we can't look at someone and judge by appearance. We're supposed to judge by spirit, their spirit, because the spirit is going to manifest